Now that we have our animated potion complete, let's take a look at our options with saving and exporting sprites that we've made with Piskel. Now that our potion sprite is complete, we have several options for saving and exporting it. Let's take a look at what we can do. To save a sprite, click on the disk icon over here. You can name your sprite here under Title. I'll name it Potion. You can give it a description. Potion icon for my new game. Now, I'm logged into my Piskel account, so I have some extra options here than if you are not logged in or don't have an account. You can still save your Piskel files if you don't have an account, but signing up does let you upload all your sprites to a gallery. This checkbox here lets you decide if you want this sprite to be available to the public or not, through your gallery. All of my sprites are set to private, so if you went to my gallery, it would be empty, but when I log in, all of my artwork is there for me. The button just below the public checkbox lets you save the sprite to your gallery. If I click it, Piskel saves the image. Now, if I click on my gallery, you can see the potion sprite has been saved. Let's open the Save tab again, and below that, we have Save Offline in Browser. This lets you save the sprite as a Piskel file in your browser's local data. Last, you can save as a Piskel file to your hard drive. After you save the file, you can load it up under the Import tab. Let's take a look at the export options we have available. I really like this option here, Scale. Scale lets you scale up the size of the sprite or animation that you just created. So, this potion is 16 pixels by 16 pixels. If you need it to be twice as big, just drag the slider up to 32 by 32. You can scale the sprite up to 32 times its original scale. We have four options for exporting a sprite. The first is GIF. You can download the sprite as an animated GIF. However, the opacity will not be preserved. So, if I open up this GIF, you can see a white background has been applied. If you need to give a link of your sprite to someone else, you can upload as an animated GIF to a public URL. Piskel gives me this URL. If I open it, you can see the potion in the browser. Let's set the scale to 32 times. And open it up. The next option is to export as a PNG sprite sheet. If I set columns to 1 and set the scale to 1, it will give me 12 rows. Remember, the animation is 12 frames long, so this will create a sprite sheet with one column with each frame of the animation on a new row. If I set columns to 2, the sprite sheet will be split into two columns with 6 rows, 2 frames in each row. If you want your sprite sheet to be aligned left to right instead of top to bottom, turn the columns higher than rows. If I set to 6 columns with 2 rows, we get 2 horizontal rows of frames. Next, you can download a zip file containing PNG files for each frame of the animation. You can give each frame a prefix name, and you can split each layer into its own PNG file as well. Last, under Others, you can export as a C file with the frames rendered as an array. Thanks for watching. If you found this content helpful, please consider supporting me on Patreon. Comment, like, and share this video, and subscribe for more tutorials. See you next time.